just decompressing. Not to worry.
You think that you could wear bigger gloves?
It's to protect the door. And my hands.
John!
Out of my way, Allie.
No, in my office.
No!
Excuse me. Pardon me. Look out! What the hell is going on?
What gives you the right to just yank me by the ear and...
John, what is it? Now, come on, you're railing last night about people don't change. Now, you talk to me now.
I've made a big mistake.
Tell me.
Allie, before you came to this firm, I never went down to the bar after work. I never talked to anyone. Except for Richard, I was content to be this litigant savant because there was safety in it. There was safety in it. And you brought me out. And I'm grateful for it, don't get me wrong, but you also made me believe that I was mainstream. And I totally bought into it. It's like Richard says, you know, you're this beautiful girlfriend. I'm also fascinated with frogs. I draft my closing arguments in bare feet. Remnants in toilet bowls actually traumatize me. I can only make love to a woman if I pretend I'm Barry White. And I'll tell you, just when I think I'm normal, my nose whistles as if to remind me that I'm not.
John, if you were to look up normal in a thesaurus, you would probably see the word ordinary. You are maybe the most extraordinary person I have ever met. You say I brought you out. If I did, it wasn't because I convinced you you were normal. It's because I got you to embrace how wonderful all your little eccentricities are. Now, you know, I've always considered you kind of a soulmate because we're fellow weirdos.
I think maybe when I saw myself in those newscasts, I saw a little weirdo. And...
Where you'd rather be a standard, typical lawyer?